Hey guys, it's Kelly. I am fresh out of the shower and I've had my hair up in a wet bun. I put it up there last night. It's pretty dry. I'm hoping that it's going to be dry soon. Anyway, I am going to be doing a get ready with me, and it's going to be kind of chatty. You guys seem to like those. I have put nothing on my face other than washing it. I did put on my bye-bye under eye cream. It's a really very emollient, and it actually kind of gets in the corners of your eyes a little bit. But I put that on to kind of reduce some of the swelling. When I put my ears on, because when you shower, it causes a lot of frizz. So I'm going to do that, and let's get started. We're going to start from the bottom and go up. I want to try this. I'm going to put this up here. I want to try this again. This from First Aid Beauty, if you're new. It is a new, it's Coconut Skin Smoothie Priming Moisturizer. So it's a moisturizer and a primer in one from First Aid Beauty. I love this brand. So we're just going to see how it goes. But first, I want to give my skin a quick drink of water with my Smashbox Primer Water. It usually dries really fast. And plus, I do have a family, so if that is... if that bothers anybody, I'm so sorry, but this hot-natured woman needs a fan. Plus, it gets really hot in here because the sun is coming in. I really need to put some blackout curtains up, but I don't even know where I'm going to be living this time next year, so why bother? I'll just put a fan on me. Okay, so what I'm going to do now then, I am going to do a full face. I am going with my friend to a Christmas program at a church, so I'm going to put just as much on my face as I would any other moisturizer. So, about like that. It kind of, I'm just going to kind of, my whole face needs to be moisturized. Even though we have days of warmth here, I noticed that here and here, my face will sometimes get flaky. And, okay. Pushing the fat up. Okay, so it's fully moisturized now, and I used this as a primer yesterday. I only just really used touches of concealer because it was just a light day. This is going to be the first time that I use that primer underneath my foundation. So we're going to see how that works. Who knows? Okay, so anyway, I was saying in my vlog before I started this that usually what I do, first thing in the morning after I've had my coffee, of course, when I get out of the shower, I just go ahead and put my PJs back on while I'm getting ready, because if I drop something and mess up my clothing, that would be yucky. So that's what I'm going to continue with. So I have my PJs back on again. Plus, it's just comfortable to be, you know, when you're spending time getting ready, especially if it's going to take you a long time, I like to be comfy. Okay, so we're going to go in with my Born This Way foundation, and it is in the color Nude. Oh, actually, I need to color correct first, don't I? Okay, let's do some color correcting before I do that. We may even do eyes. Let's just do our eyes, because I'm not really sure what I want to do with my eyes. I do want it to be festive, so I may add a touch of gold. I'm going to be using my Anastasia Renaissance palette. This is one of the most wonderful palettes ever, guys. I mean, it really is. So I'm going to go in with my NARS, and we'll just get this ball rolling. I'll get my... uh-oh, sorry. That was loud. Let's get this ball rolling, and hopefully it'll seem like I know what I'm doing. At least not so much know what I'm doing as much as at least not be so haphazard. I'm not a makeup artist, but I've got lots of years of experience of putting it on myself. So we'll just say that it's a, I'm not elderly. We'll just say it's life experience. That's what we'll call it. Okay. So I have just, you know, I know that a primer on the lid always helps. I mean, it just does. I mean, there's, you know, there's no way around it, really. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this brush from Luxie. It just says it's the tapered blending, but it's kind of fluffy. I'm just going to use this to go into this color Tempera. I want to put something that's close to my skin tone all over the eye to set that primer I just put down because it's sticky. It dries down to a sticky finish. And you need to put something down to cover that. And what it does is it gives you a barrier so that if you have oily eyelids, which a lot of people do, then that's going to really help using a primer on your lids. And I would suggest this one from NARS, but if you want a good one from the drugstore, Milani has one. This one right here, so y'all know what you're looking for. It is awesome. It's the best one from the drugstore, but it's really good. And what you do is you put it on there, you rub it until it has kind of dried down and gotten just a little bit tacky. And then when you're running your brush over with this, you know, kind of skin tone color, if you feel it tug at your brush any at all, that's just a place where it's not gotten powder on it. So what this is going to do is it's going to give us a really soft, silky base in order to blend in. So I'm going to take my E40 from Sigma. It's a little bit bigger than that one. I'm going to go into this color called Warm Taupe. It's a really pretty light brown color. And I'm going to put that in my crease. Now I have hooded lids. And because I have hooded lids, I have to go a little bit above the crease. So if you have hooded lids, go a little bit above your actual crease. You can go in and above. But I always start on the outer corner when you go in, because you want the most of the color to be on the outer corner and you want to be bringing it in and blending. And Lord knows, your hand can fall off if you have to blend a lot. So if you're doing a fairly difficult look, you're going to do a lot of blending. And the best thing I can say to you is if you have hooded lids, keep your eyes slightly open. Start in the outer corner. You can always clean that up if needed. Start in that outer corner and go just slightly in and above your actual crease. That way, the color won't be hidden in that deep crease from your hooded lid. And I'm kind of, you know, going into a lot of depth because I have a lot more followers now and more subbies. And I haven't done a detailed, you know, get ready with me in a long time where I talk about the technical stuff. So if you're new, I'm doing this for you. Okay, so it's fun for everybody else to watch, but I'm giving you some pointers as we go. If you don't have a hooded lid, you don't have to worry about it. Just put it directly in your crease, but you want a good crease color, something that is going to be easy to build on and that sort of thing. So you can see already that my eye is kind of taking shape just with the one crease color. Okay, and you can see it because it's above that. You see my mobile lid is very small. When I close my eye, you can see everything, but that mobile lid area, the one that I blink, the part that actually blinks, you know, if I was to put it only in that crease right there, you know, it's not going to show. So you keep your head back just a little bit and your eyes open just a little bit so you can actually see where you're putting it. And that helps tremendously. Okay, now I'm going to go in. I'm trying to decide what I want to do. I think I am going to go for just a warm brown look. So I'm going to take this. It is a Morphe E28. It's a little bit more of a precise brush. It is stained. I used a red and kind of stained it just a little bit. So let's make sure. Yeah, it's clean. Okay, I'm going to go into Cypress Umber, which is another, but this is a really, really pigmented dark. Knock off the extra. Don't ever go in straight from the palette. Okay, I'm going to put this in my outer corner in the outer V, and I'm going to slowly bring it into the crease. So head back. Start right here. Just kind of back and forth, back and forth. And then you can start bringing it into the crease just a little bit. So you're going to cover your outer V just like that. Do you see how it's blending that darker color into? We're going to go back and blend later after I've put this in. But I wanted you to see exactly what I'm doing. Because that outer V, it's always nice when it's darker than the rest of the look. Okay, now, it looks like it kind of took over just a little bit, but what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back in with that same brush that we used, that warm taupe? Yeah, the warm taupe. No additional product. We're just gonna go in, we're just gonna kind of go over it just a little bit, and you can use circular motions or you can go back and forth with windshield wiper motions. It's whatever you're comfortable with. Sometimes I do both. But what I like to do with no additional product, I like to go in and just really blend those two together. And it makes it look so much nicer. And since it doesn't have any additional product in it, you're not worrying about overdoing it. I hope that you can understand what I'm trying to say there. Just don't go in with any additional product and then start working out that line. You want it to be nice and soft. You don't want it to be a harsh line between those two. Then you look at what you've got to work with, and you can see that, or at least I hope you can see, that this eye, the darker brown doesn't come up as high. So I'm just going to kind of work it in right there just a little bit, just to make it even. And then back to the original brush with no extra product. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do for now. Let's look at the actual mobile lid. Let me find a good brush that I can kind of use. This is the one that I prefer to use. It's a Sigma E70. It's just a little angled fluffy brush. I like to use this when I am putting something on the mobile lid itself. And I do want to do something, since it's a Christmas program I'm going to, I do want to do something that has a little bit of color. So I'm going to go into Primavera, which is this beautiful gold color. I'm going to go into that. Knock off the extra, just like I said. I'm going to put this all over not just the mobile lid, but the inner corner V, or the inner V of the lid. I just want to bring some lightness in where that dark is. Okay. I'm getting a little bolder here because I'm not really, it's buildable, and so because it's buildable, you know, you kind of have to work at it, add more. Okay, do you see how it's starting to lighten up? I hope you can see the difference between the two eyes. Now, I'm going to go into the other eye. I'm just working on that inner eye, kind of going up into the edge of what I call my crease. Okay. Didn't want to go in my crease there. Now let's see. Yeah. Okay, so what I've done is I've lightened it up a bit. Now, back to my original. And I'm just going to kind of go, but I'm just going to kind of wiggle between the colors where they meet, and it helps blend them and gives it more of an ombre look than just a, you know, that harsh change. I hope that makes sense. I just kind of wiggled it in between where the gold meets the brown, the darkest brown. And that's what I have so far. Okay, it's really not that hard. I will come back in and I will do my brow and my under eye shortly, but let me go ahead and check for any fallout just in case, even though I don't have on any makeup yet. I don't want to start smearing dark colors on my face. Okay, now I'm going to go into my color correcting. Now I use, I hope you guys can see. Can you see how much of this I've used? I mean, I've been using it like crazy. It is the Urban Decay Skin Color Correction Fluid, and mine is in green. You'll notice that I have tons of redness all over my face, and I like to try and camouflage that as much as I can. And I have just found that this works wonders for me. Let me put a dot on my nose. I'm going to do just the top of my cheek where it's red first. And then I'm going to come back, because I have broken capillaries in my face and things like that. It's just part of being, you know, my age. But I'm going to take a damp beauty blender, and I'm just going to kind of, there's a water running somewhere. Okay, so I just kind of bounce that in, and it covers that redness just a touch. I just want to get, my nose is red just a little bit, so I decided to put a little dot on there. It camouflages so well. I mean, I've been using this like crazy because it does such a good job. Now, I have really fallen in love with my Born This Way foundation. I have drugstore and high-end, and this is the one that I reach for the most. It usually, I don't even put it up, but you can see how it toned down that red. Okay, now let me show you what I'm talking about in this area, because this shows through my makeup. So I put a little bit on my chin, and I'm just going to bounce on that with a damp beauty blender, and the redness is camouflaged. That's amazing, isn't it, guys? Okay, let's do the same to the other side. You know, it just, I don't do this every time I get ready. I mean, you know, because that's expensive. That's expensive. Kathleen Lights would say that. That would be too expensive. But usually, I mean, I'm doing a full face for you today. Like, full-blown full face. Now, normally, I don't conceal and do all of this extra unless I am going somewhere special, getting out, and that sort of thing. Never know who I might meet tonight. Got to be prepared. Okay, so I just want to camouflage that redness. I do have a dark spot, which is just an age spot, but most of the time, you know, my foundation will cover that up. Okay, now I'm being very careful not to get anything. The only thing I've done is moisturize with that eye cream, and then I put the moisturizer slash primer from First Day Beauty, I put that all over. This is the only thing underneath my eyes at this point. I want to keep as much off the under eye as area as possible, because it's cakey if you're not careful, if you get too much product underneath there. So when I go to put on my Born This Way foundation, I'm going to be really careful. I'm still going to use my beauty blender, and I'm going to bounce it out just like I did before. I'm going to put a squirt on the back of my hand, but I am not going to get any of this underneath the eye. That's what the concealers are going to do, and I'm going to be doing my Smashbox color correcting stick under there for the dark circles. So I just go on the back of my hand like this right here. Sometimes I use, I have a glass, plate that I like to dump things out on, especially if I'm mixing foundations, which I don't do. I mean, very rarely. I'm getting this bone. I'm just not getting that underneath the eye. At least it doesn't feel like I am. I'm trying to stay away from it. Okay. I need to be looking in the mirror and seeing what I'm doing here. Let me tell my son something. Hey, son, there's a new thing of bread with that cheese and ham. You can make ham and cheese sandwiches if you're hungry. Or make a pizza. It's up to you.
Okay.
I have a 17-year-old, for those of you that might not know. And he's my world. I love him. I love him so much. And he and I, I think that everybody gets into battles sometimes. He's always been treated like an adult, though. And the only issue with that is that he tends to want to talk to me as though he's an adult. And so we kind of have a few little, we have a row every now and then. And, but he's all I've got. And I just feel like that somebody's got to teach him some respect, And so he and I clash sometimes when, he'll say, "Well, you interrupted me." I am your mama. I get to speak first. Okay, now I've done my cheeks. I usually do the center of my face, my T-zone first, but for some reason today, don't know why, I just started on the cheeks. But let's go now into the forehead and down the nose area with the foundation. I just squirted out a little bit more. And I'm just bouncing. You don't ever want to sweep. First of all, it's not good to pull, to tug at your skin like that. But secondly, with a beauty blender, you get a supernatural finish just by bouncing. You don't want to, if you do this, you're going to get streaks. That, or at least that's what happens 90% of the time. Okay. I did put some chapstick on before I started, and that's really important because your lips tend to get really dry while you're getting ready to go somewhere. And I may not even put on my lip choice until I'm ready to walk out the door. So just to keep that in mind, that might not be part, I'll add it onto the end of this video. Okay, now you can do this, and you need to do this. You need to make sure that you've gotten right there in front of and your ear to make sure there's no area that, looks. And then you can go down your neck. If it doesn't match just right, go down your neck just a little bit with your foundation. But always check your jawline to make sure you don't have any demarcation lines, because nobody likes the way that looks. So, it's not a good look for anybody. Okay, I don't know what I did with the lid to my foundation. Oh, here it is. Okay, so I'm going to put that away. Now then, let's go on to the rest of our face. Wipe my hands off a little bit. I hate to get that on me. You know what I'm saying? Now I need to find, I think this is it. Sorry if that was loud. This is my Smashbox. It's color correcting stick. It says look less tired. And mine is in the dark orange. You can get a light orange, but mine are pretty severe. So, I go with the dark one. Let me move my mirror in just a little bit. And let's see here. I'm looking to make sure that I don't have it. I've got it on the magnified side, my mirror, to make sure that I didn't miss a spot. Sometimes you can miss a spot like around here or on your temples, things like that. And then I'm just checking my neck. Do you see how, even the redness, you can still see it, but it's not something you would notice right away. Do you see how it kind of shines through anyway? It's just, those of us that battle any kind of discoloration, that's just kind of what we have to deal with. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this. I need to sharpen it. I'm going to go in this area. I have really bad dark circles here, and I tend to be discolored there at the corner of my eye. So I just put this there, and then I take this really soft, it's really soft. It's a Sigma E55. It says eye shading, but since it's so soft, I like to use it to, blend out my under eye. And this does make me look very sickly. I will admit that. It makes me look very sickly. But you know, it, when I put my concealer on over it, it helps so much. Now, it's not going to fill in this depth. I mean, it's actually really deep. But it does help with the color of it. So, this is the first thing that I, besides my moisturizer, that I put underneath my eye. And then, I blend it out really good. And, you know, if you're not sure, if you have, under eye circles, there's NYX has one, and there's tons of different brands at Sephora. I have found over the course of looking, though, that this really dark orange works best for me because mine are pretty severe. Like I said, if I could get filler stuck in here, it wouldn't look quite so bad because it still looks like I have bags under my eyes with my makeup on, but they're not purple. And this orange really does do a good job of, you know, transforming this once I get that underneath my eye. Okay, now let's go in with, I want to make sure that I just went ahead and put that back away. I did. Okay, now I'm going to go in with the Born This Way concealer as well. It just so happens that, you know, I like these two together. This one works really well for me. My favorite from the drugstore is the Maybelline Fit Me. You can see that it's just about empty, but I do have a backup. But the Born This Way in Light is what I'm going to be using. And I know a lot of beauty gurus, they, you know, do that triangle or whatever, and they fill it in, and it's really heavy and everything. I have found that that doesn't really work for me. Now, they do contour their nose down the side, and because I do feel like that my nose is a little wide through this area, when I dot, I do come down the side, just so that when I am blending out, it lightens that area, and it gives me the appearance of a little bit more narrow nose. And so I'm going to dot, dot, dot right there where I put all of that. I'm going to dot down that side just like that. Since I have a fan on me, I'm just going to do one edge at one side, one side at a time. I'm going to use the point of my beauty blender and I'm going to bounce. Do not ever do this. Don't ever do anything like that. Even when you're rubbing in your moisturizer, be careful of your under eyes because that tissue is so tender and it can be damaged so easily. So if you are still young, do we see the difference? I'm not going to be able to get rid of that right there, but at least it's not as purple as it was. I hope that makes sense. I would love to get it taken care of, but that takes more money than what I've got. I need to live. And now that my dog is on expensive dog food, I mean, it's going to be a hardship. So I'm going to have to really watch my bills now. Because her food is probably going to take up my fun money. And I call it fun money. It's the money that I usually try to put back just a little bit so that I can do hauls for y'all. And, you know, whether it's beauty and or Etsy or anything like that, you know, for my planner. I accidentally got it a little too high up. I don't really need concealer in my eyeball. Okay, now I have lots of fine lines, but I think you can see now I look way less tired. The purple is gone. It's been concealed. So what I'm ready to do next, I have got it in my eye. There's no doubt. Now what I believe that you, everybody needs to know is that I'm going to be using the Laurie Mercier loose translucent powder. This is pretty much what you see everybody use, but it's for good reason. I mean, the stuff is absolutely wonderful. There's other good ones. The one from the drugstore, excuse me, the NYC loose powder in translucent works beautifully as well. I'm going to set anywhere that I put concealer. I I didn't put it down my face. You know, I didn't want to do that. I'm fine. I think the way that, you know, I think that what you have to do is you have to decide for yourself, how much do you want to do? Exactly how much time do you want to spend? And how heavy and how, you know, full blown of a face do you really want? So what I'm going to do now, while that's baking or cooking, you can call it really whatever you want. While I'm doing that, I'm going to get my brush. I'm going to go into my new Hourglass palette. I'm going to use this to set the rest of my face. So I'm just going to kind of go into that. And I'm going to start setting the rest of my face. It's a luminous powder. It's not shimmery. It does not have any glitter. And it does not look luminous until at the end when I spray on my finishing spray. It just gives me a healthy look as opposed to that chalky dead look. I really like this powder. I've been using it like crazy. Okay, now what I'm going to do is get a little bit of that, and I'm going to knock off any extra powder left from where I baked my under eye. Now, it's going to look a little bit cakey and a little bit wrinkly. Okay, so I had been, for the longest time, I had been just kind of, you know, wishing that there was something I could do about that. I have to conceal, you know, just about everybody does have to conceal something. But, you know, I never liked the way that my under eyes looked. Well, I've got a product that solved that problem for me, so I will go into that shortly. But for now, I'm going to use my Hourglass brush that I got, and I'm going to go in. I like to kind of go into the bronzer and a little bit of that, and that's what I like to warm up my face with, just kind of bronze up just a little bit, give myself a little bit of color. I try to, you know, kind of hit wherever the sun would hit. So for me, that's here. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go into my Kat Von D Shade and Light palette, her contour palette. This has lasted me forever because I have so many different products and I forget what I've got. You know what I'm saying? Okay, I'm going to go in. I bought the brush that goes with that. I'm going to use the angled end. I'm going to go into this. I like to mix these two together. I'm going to use that angle and I'm going to contour just a little bit because I have a very round face. So I'm going to start at the corner of my ear. I'm going to come down and that's where I'm going to contour at. If you blend, you need to blend up. Okay. But yeah, just align with your top of your ear. And if not, just feel your bone and go right in that hollow right beneath it. And don't blend down because you'll have, you know, it'll get messy. And I still like to sometimes go in and fix it anyway, just to make it sharper. Okay, now I did that, and the reason I did that and the bronzer, I'm gonna go in with just my normal brush and I'm just gonna kind of blend that together. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm going to go in with my Laura Mercier again. And I'm just going to clean that up a little bit. So I'm just going to go in with and get some of that powder. I'm just going to put it there like that. And what it does is it gives you a sharper look. Do you see the difference? I'm just cleaning it up a little bit. Okay, let's let that sit for a minute. And I'm going to be putting on my blush. Now my blush, I'm still in the Hourglass palette. I'm going to use this blush here, right here. and it is beautiful. I'm going to use the other end of my hourglass, and I'm just going to kind of go in there, and I'm going to start not right on the apples of my cheek, but above where I have been contouring and bronzing. I'm just going to kind of start sort of underneath the corner of my eye, and I'm going to start bringing it back. It just looks more natural that way. I've changed that. I used to just go right on the apple of my cheek and bring it back just a little bit, like in a teardrop shape. But now I just kind of, you know, I put it on top of where I have contoured and bronzed. That way, when I go to blend, it all kind of blends together and it looks very natural. Okay, now I'm going to put that away. Let's go in with my brush. I'm going to clean this up. See how much better it looks, guys? Now I look like I have cheekbones. Can you see? It looks like I have cheekbones. If you place it in the right place, that's what happens. Now, I also want to go in and make sure that all of these products that I've put on my face are blended together and we have no sharp lines. So I just lightly go over those, blending upwards to make sure that they're blended. The nice straight line there, we want, because that's what gives us our cheekbone look. I just love the way that, you know, makeup, there's something on my face. I love that the way makeup, you know, can really change the way that we look. Okay, it's time to go back to our eyes. I'll do highlight and those kinds of things last. Okay, I want to go back into my Renaissance palette. And what I'm going to do, I have a pencil brush here. It is a Sigma E30, and it says pencil brush on it. I'm going to go into the Cypress Umber that I used in the outer corner. And I'm going to bring that on my lower lash line. I mean, like, really close. And then all right, now, let's get a brush that's just a touch fluffier because I want to kind of smoke it out just a little bit. That one's maybe, this one's a little bit, okay, I'm going to go into the warm taupe that we used in the crease. I'm just going to kind of smoke this out a little bit. I like to close my eyes when I'm doing this because I just find that it keeps it out of my eyes, and as a contact wear, it just seems to help. Okay, now, I had some fallout, so let's get rid of that. Okay. Now then, I'm finished with that. No, I'm not. I need to do my brow bone. Okay, let me go in with the same, let's go in with Vermeer because it's more of a pinky pearl color. I think that'll be pretty on our brow bone. And I think I'll also use it on my inner corner. I'm just going to kind of feather it into that brown. I'm not coming all the way in with it. I'm trying to keep it there. Okay, let's see here. Just feathering it in. It's such a beautiful color. Okay, let me go back into the original brush that I used for my outer V. And I'm just blending to make sure that it's nice and even. Now I'm finished with my palette and I can put that away. Okay, what I'm going to do next after kind of, I just like to dust very often. It just keeps things under control, I guess you could say. Okay, now then, I just had my brows tinted yesterday, so I really don't have to do anything much with those, but I have gotten into the habit where I just save that for last. That's the last thing I do, because as I'm putting in or putting on some highlight and things like that, I tend to hit my brows. So let's just finish up our eyes. Now, I have been absolutely loving this eye pencil by MAC, and it is in the color Costa Riche. It's beautiful. I found out about it from Kathleen Lights. That's the second time I've mentioned her. Can you tell I love her? I just absolutely love her. Okay, so this is beautiful. It is a warm, rich brown. I'm going to tight line and waterline, and it is going to make my eyes a little watery, you know, and a little irritated looking, but it'll go away. So I'm just going to tight line. And I know some people can't stand to look at that. But if you're careful, and keep in mind, I have contacts in, so that protects my eyes to a great deal. It's a really nice color for the look that I went for. Okay. Now then, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful color. Okay, what I want to do now, I want to go ahead and at least use my Anastasia Brow Wiz and kind of, let's see, I need to brush them at least just to see where the sparser areas are after being tinted. And then I'm just going to fill those in and spoolie. This one is in pretty good shape. I did trim them myself last night. You do have to trim your brow sometimes, guys. It's, you have to maintain your brows. You really do. Okay. Now, this one is sparse. It's sparse in many areas. It's not as thick as the other one. Even when they've been tinted, because see, I have a lot of blonde brow hair, and so even after they've been tinted, I still have to work on this one a good bit just to get it even with the other one, which it looks pretty good right now. Okay, so let me spoolie through. So you really don't have to do much when they're tinted, other than work on this side over here. I just go in really light-handed. To me, if you go in really light-handed and then you spoolie it out, I think you'll see better results than if you go in heavy-handed. It doesn't take me very long to get it really like I want it, just because, I mean, you know, I'm so light. I just go in so tenderly. Okay, now it is time for some mascara, and I need to curl my lashes. I'm going to curl them first this time. So let's get these babies in here. Okay. I'm going to be using the Tarte Lights Camera Flashes. This has been a sample that has, it's been unbelievable how it has lasted. Now again, on a regular basis, daily, I really don't wear makeup that much. Very rarely. Sometimes I like to come and play in my makeup, you know, and that sort of thing. I do like to play in my makeup, but, you know, I'm just a normal person, and right now I'm a little self-conscious about the way that I look physically, and it's not that I don't care. It's that sometimes I just feel like that, you know, it doesn't matter if I put makeup on or not. It's not going to make a difference. And that's really not good. I need to get up and put it on every day without fail, no matter what. But my makeup does tend to last a little bit longer, just because I'm not using it daily. Okay, now, bottom lashes. If I make a mistake, you can always wait till it's dry, use a Q-tip or, you know, a cotton swab and clean it up. But you have to make sure that it's dry. Okay, that is what I look like. Now, you can see I've got some mistakes and everything, but that's fine. I'm going to let those dry. Let's go in with the highlighter that I'm going to use. I had forgotten about my Laura Geller Gilded Honey, so I decided that I wanted to use it today. I've been stuck on my Champagne Pop or my Wet n Wild one, and I just decided, now this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills A23 or something like that for highlight. I'm just going to kind of go in there and get a good dose of it. I'm not, because I'm older, I have to avoid this area here. I mean, I have to avoid that area very much so. But I do like to put it right there at the point of my brow, on my temple. I do not have any texture on my skin. So if you have texture on your skin, you're going to need to be very careful with highlight. It's called baked gelato or whatever. And so it doesn't come out quite as strong as like a Becca or any other, you know, a drugstore or anything like that. I have to kind of go over it a couple of times until I build it up to the degree that I like it. But you can see, I hope, how pretty it is. But I do keep it away from my under eye. And this brush is one of the better purchases, I believe, that I've made. And I say that because it's absolutely, I mean, it's designed for highlight and it does such a great job. It's nice, it's triangular, it's nice and poofy at the end. But remember, if you're older and you have fine lines, don't put highlight anywhere that you have wrinkles. Anywhere you have wrinkles, you need to keep the highlight away from that. And I am slowly learning in my makeup journey that it's okay for people with hooded eyes or mature skin to use satin shadows on my eyes. That it's not, you know, gonna, I mean, if you're careful, you can do it, and you know, you pay attention to what you're doing, then you can get down my nose. And of course, I'm gonna do my Cupid's bow. But, you know, you just have to kind of play and learn your own. Okay, let me find, I have got a little brush somewhere. Okay, I'm going to use this little brush. I'm going to go in. And I'm just going to do this. Because I want my lips to really look like a good pucker. And, this is definitely extra. But when I go to do my lips, see how pretty it stands out and makes my lip. Okay. Going underneath that too. See how it makes my lips stand out. So when I go to put my, let me put this away. When I go to put on my lip color, it's going to look really nice. Okay, now the last thing that I'm going to do, my brows, and then what I normally do for my under eye. All I'm doing is just barely going through my brows with this NYX brow mascara and brunette. I'm only doing it just to lay them in place so they'll stay still and they won't go anywhere. And they'll stay just like I want them to stay. Now, let's go in with a cotton swab. Let me get a cotton swab. And we're going to go in and get any mascara. All right, this is what I learned to, you know, I said earlier when I was talking to you about my under eyes, I told you that even though I conceal and everything, that they still seem so dry looking. That's when I found Kiehl's Ultra Facial Toner. And Wayne Goss talked about this, and he showed it does need to be shaken up. What you do is you go into the tip of your beauty blender with just a couple of drops. See it drip, it dripped in my lap. Yet another reason, and it only takes just a drop or two, and then I just press. It has, what did he call it? Squalene. It has squalene in it. I'll pop the name of that up on the name of the product and the ingredient. I'll pop that up on the screen for you. But what it does is it takes away, I've got this huge thing, it's 8 ounces, and I used like 2 drops, literally 2 drops. And so, I mean, that'll last me a lifetime. It'll go bad way before, you know, I need it. But I have just found that that works really, really well. Okay, so the next thing that I would normally do is go ahead and set my my face. And because I really do need it to last, I'm going to be using, this is the Scandinavia Finishing Spray. And I'm just going to kind of spray it over my face. You're supposed to do an X and a T. I just kind of spray wherever I feel like that it's hitting my face. So I'm just going to go in with that. Okay, it's gonna dry. I hope that you guys can see what I was talking about with the highlighter. This is, you know, it's not my most in your face look or whatever, but it's nice and neutral, and I can wear a pretty lip. I'm probably gonna go with a nude lip because I'm really not sure what I'm wearing yet. So the next time you see me, my hair will be done and I will be dressed. So I will come back in just a minute to put my lip on and show you guys what I look like. I'll be right back. Okay guys, I have let my hair down, so it's nice and just has beachy waves in it. I put a little bit of blow dry lotion in it from OGX, and then I just dried the roots and kind of fluffed up the ends just a little so it didn't look flat, and then I just pulled all of it up with a little clip to keep it out of my face. Now I am ready for the last things before we walk out the door. Okay, so I already have my jewelry on, my earrings, I'm ready to go. I'm going to use Kat Von D's Everlasting Liquid Lipstick in Bow and Arrow. If you have been watching me, you know that that is one of my favorites. I did overline just a touch right here. Okay, and you can see that highlight at the top there. Now, that dries pretty fast, I would say. Those are my favorite. That is absolutely my favorite formula for liquid lipstick for a matte. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in with this Marc Jacobs lip gloss in Sugar Sugar. You guys know that I recently hauled it and I've been addicted with it ever since. I'm just going to go in the center and kind of give myself a little bit of a shine. It's like peppermint, sort of. It is a little sticky. It dries down just a touch, but the stickiness pretty much stays there. But it gives it such a pretty ombre in the center of the lip, and it makes your lips look poutier. I like that. Okay, the next thing that I have to do is I am hooked on my Elizabeth and James Black and White, their Nirvana. What I do is I do put this on my pulse points and wherever else I decide I might want to. I like to mix them. These are roller balls. So I just kind of do this little number here. And then I go in with the white and do the same thing. And it just creates this wonderful smell of, it's just yummy, guys. That's the only thing I can say. And I'm so addicted to it. I really don't know how much of this I've used because you can't see through, but I'm sure it's a lot. Okay, so guys, let me take you and I will give you a full outfit of the day. Hey guys, I am in my son's bathroom, so it's a little bit echoey, but I just want to kind of show you, you know, what I've got going.
It's a little bit better.
Okay, this is my outfit of the day. I have on black leggings, and they are from Walmart, but they have like a really nice seam down the front. This tunic is really, really soft, and it is from Kim Rogers. His mirror is dirty. It's from Kim Rogers, which is a Belk store brand. And then I have on these booties. These booties are from Born, and they're really, really cute. They have a nice heel on them, and they have the buckle detail, which I really, really like. So this is my outfit of the day, and I'm ready to go.
Okay, guys, that's going to be it. I hope you guys enjoyed my get ready with me. I haven't done one in a really long time, and I was looking forward to a chance to do it, and this was perfect.
So if you like this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed, what are you waiting on? Go ahead and hit that subscribe button and also click yes on notifications, the little bell. Click on that so that you can get notified every time I upload, which is every day. And I'm also doing Vlogmas. So I'm just trying to take you around and show you a peek into my life and what it's like. But again, thank you for watching this video. I appreciate all of my subscribers so much. You're so sweet and so supportive. I love you guys, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.